Hi guys, it's Mr. Police Gaming, and we are here with a brand new game on Steam, under $10. It's called Monster Loves You! Explanation Point, and it was released today. Under genre, it's listed as an adventure, RPG, indie, casual, simulation. I made the simulation. It's this cute thing I do with, never mind. Firstly, how pleasant is this music? I'm going to turn it down a bit though. It's a little too pleasant. I don't want you guys getting, you know, too into it right at the start here. So, what is Monster Loves You? It's an excellent question because I haven't played it yet. Monster Loves You, about the game. This is what it's got listed in Steam. This is what its selling points are. You live the life of a monster from birth to elderhood and beyond, making decisions that affect the world of monsters and humans. You live in the village of Omen. You know, I've noticed this about video games. A lot of places, a lot of villages or cities or lands, they're called Omen. It's just something I've noticed. You never see anything called Geelong. It's always Omen. Anyway, you live in the village of Omen, and your favourite snack is the fingers of small children, like in this game already. As a monster, you pop up in the most interesting places. What do you do when three angry bears discover a young child in their cabin? That seems familiar. Or when you spy a wolf hunting down that woman with the red cloak? That also sounds familiar. As a monsterling, your choices are simple ones. Do you chase those poor little mice or protect them from the dogs? Do you come clean about the fungus your friends ate or cover for them? As a youth, your choices determine your personality. Such is life. Such is life. But all young'uns must grow up. Monster and humans have been at odds for centuries, and there are human villages on the other side of the enchanted woods. When human children get lost in those dark and winding thickets, do you terrorize them for fun? Do you help return them to human civilization to prove that not all monsters are to be feared and hated? Or do you fatten them up for the human foie gras, a monster delicacy? All this to the backdrop of increasing tensions between monsters and humankind. The key features, there's only 4 dot points, so I'll go through them. Balance bravery, cleverness, ferocity, honesty, kindness, and respect to wield political power. Oh, I didn't expect a political aspect to my monsters game, but no, there you go, it's right there. Over 900 choices to make. Devour Little Red Riding Hood. Gobble up Hansel and Gretel. Eat the three little pigs. That seems like the same choice. No matter what scenario, you have the same choice. Eat everything. Which is good. I wish we could live life like that. Encounter different adventures each time you play, with a dozen or so possible endings. Bonus. Become a neurosurgeon without having to attend medical school. That's value. That is value. I've always wanted to be a neurosurgeon, and I never wanted to go to medical school. Alright, so let's actually jump into the game and see how it plays. Alright. Help me begin your story. How does it go again? Long ago, deep in the forest, monsters called the Whale Mist. I don't have any options, so I guess I'm just going to click that. That's right. Long ago, nestled in the heart of the forest, was the monster village of Omen. You are born from slime that holds the memory of monsters known for actions and attitude, or words and thoughts. Let's go with words and thoughts. But then again, I am a man of action. I'm divided already. Hopefully I don't have to name my monster or else we're screwed. You're not awake yet, but soon your first eye will open. Just makes me, I don't know why that made me laugh, but your first eye will open. Just made me chuckle. Your simple dreams will give way to life itself. You dream of helping the sick and soothing the woeful. I'm a good guy, but I'm not that good. Outsmarting everyone else. I do like the sound of that. Speaking true when others lie. No, we're outsmarting everyone. Your body is turning and twisting, growing solid in the middle of a great vat of green slime. It's time to be born, and I got +9 cleverness. So I guess I click be born. Seems like that would be a good place to start, good place as any. You awaken in the chilling season, just as the air begins to turn crispy cool. Onward! Your eyes open, you're a morsel just barely born. You float in the spawning vat. Dozens of other morsels are exploring, flailing, and stealing food from each other. Okay, so I can either go try to swim, or I can go yes, but born from what, is the question. Let's go with the, let's question things. From the slime, what do you think? What is this thing, slime? It's the stuff monsters are made of. You don't actually mean, you don't mean we're actually born from this slime. Look, it's just like mold and mushrooms. It's just a sticky side of nature. When the spark of life enters a colloidal gel, monsters just happen. Fascinating. Try to swim. Another morsel swims towards you. It opens its mouth to show a set of small, sharp teeth. It bites you. Aye! Swim away from the toothy morsel, or... What? This is intolerable! Stop that biting! I think you can tell by the way I read it which one I'm going to go for. Intolerable! You pause, unable to believe that another morsel is trying to eat you. After a moment, you snap out of it and start to move again. Resist it. Kill it. Unite other morsels to repel the attack. I do like this unite other morsels option. I feel like a general already. Unite under me! Mr. Police Gaming! Slime God! You speak, your words are simple, but some of the morsels understand you. They converge on the biter. +9 honesty. Oh yeah. This aggression will not stand! Your tiny, slimy flotilla frightens the bad morsel away. It retreats to the far end of the spawning vat. Now we're going to patrol the vat and look for more trouble, because we're superheroes. Splash, flutter, splish, squeak. Another morsel is too weak to swim properly. It's sinking towards the bottom of the spawning vat. Can ignore it and swim on. Too bad that these things happen, or oh no, that's terrible. Survival of the fittest, it's too bad that these things do happen. You watch the half-formed baby monster slip beneath the surface. It begins to break apart. Yuck. Swim down and take a bite out of the weakling. Confront the hard reality of death and watch it die. Comfort the dying morsel. Look, I know we're still just a baby, we're just a morsel, but we are going to confront the harsh reality of death and watch it die. Oh, honesty, +9. You gaze, unblinking, as the little morsel dies. The weakling's limbs stick to slimy clumps on the bottom, then tear away from its body. Ugh, graphic. Continue and observe. The little morsel's mouth forms a terrified, toothless O, and then splits in three directions, forming the center of the fault lines that destroy its torso and head. Don't look away. Don't you look away. The last you see of the morsel is its eye, which now, without a lid, floats there, seeming to stare right back at you. Then it dissolves into sludge, and the sludge dissolves into nothing. Oh, we all gotta go sometime. You have grown too big for the spawning vat. You must move on to the next stage of life and become a monsterling. Got any advice? No, don't grow up. Well, none of us really want to grow up, do they? Growing up isn't something you can fight, little one. Okay. You're going too big for the spawning vat, you must move on. Alright, got any advice? You're going to get into some trouble, which is great. Exercise your bravery, cleverness, ferocity, kindness, and honesty. What kind of monster will you be? The best damn tootin' monster I can. Indeed, to the brood cave and adventure. Sort of. Okay, just clicking these bottom five things here. They're your skills, and clicking on them just tells you what they are. Tells you what your overall score is. So my honesty is 18 out of 100, and my cleverness is 9 out of 100. And everything else is nothing out of 100. What's this button do? Ah, takes you back to the menu. I don't want to go to the menu. So I have 8 days left. I don't know what happens at the end of the 8 days. I guess we click adventure. Choose your adventure. I just had to click one. I had no idea what that did. Nash, Gnash, and Gobclaws are racing to the ceiling of the cave. They've already climbed way up when Gobclaws invite you to join them. You don't see a good way up though. Look at the path they took and copy them. Just face up to it, admit you aren't much of a climber, or make a fair effort, but stop before you get hurt. Let's just copy them. Cleverness! You follow National's claw marks halfway up the cave wall, then slip sideways to where Gobclaws was being more careful. Okay, that's what it said. You meet them at the top to their surprise. What do I do now? Oh, 7 days left. I guess I click adventure again. Chicken! Hamrag, an older monster, brings a big sack full of squirming rats into the cave. As he heads for the spawning vat, he trips and all the rats spill out. Gobble some up, help some escape, help Hamrag hunt them down. Gotta be for number one. You always gotta look out for number one. We're gonna gobble those up. You block the escape of a dozen rats. Other monsterlings are closing in, but you have control of this group for now. How many will you eat? As many as I can, or just one or two? Just one or two. I don't want to get overweight. Ferocity! You snag a single rat and eat it. Not bad. Adventure! 6 days left. Spider. Something is scurrying along the walls and the ceiling and the floors. Spiders as big and round as plates. Ooh, it's creepy. They're swarming into the cave. You can't tell if they're a friend or foe. So we can confront them, stay between them and the other monsterlings, or throw blots to them as a sacrifice. Sorry, blots. It's your time to go. Oh no! My bravery and kindness were both already zero, so they're still zero, so I don't care. You seize blots and hurl him into the center of the carpet of huge spiders. They scatter away from him. He stares angrily at you as the spiders flee. Well, it worked out for everyone, didn't it? You didn't get eaten, and the spiders are gone. 3 stones. Some monsterlings are building little stone towers. Blots comes to you with a heaping armload of smooth rocks. Do you think there is enough to build a tower? Give him an honest answer. Help him build a tower. Leave me alone, Blots, I'm busy! Prank Blots nicely. Pull a mean prank on Blots. Well, I did just throw Blots to spiders, so I'm going to help him build a tower, because I feel bad. Honesty, kindness, and cleverness. Boom, boom. Like this, you point to a good flat spot on the floor, then start laying out a base for the tower. You and Blots build the best one in the cave. Oh, Blots. We do have such fun. You are halfway towards leaving, becoming an adolescent. Firm up your personality as much as you can. I'm really not very brave just now. Let's look at this guy with his angry face, I guess. You stumble on a rock and find a patch of purple lichen. Is it lichen? Lichen? Lichen, 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 behind it. Your exclamation of delight draws Smark and Gobclaws. Oh, so Smark and Gobclaws. Gobclaws isn't plural. Gobclaws is just the name of one of the monsters. Okay, that makes more sense now, for that was Gobclaws' line earlier. But there's not really enough to share. What's so special about lichen, lichen, lichen? Tell them how to find some. Invite them in anyway. They're onto you! Run away! What's so special about lichen, lichen, lichen? Monsterlings mostly eat at night, mostly. And what you eat is lichen, 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 mostly. The big lichen, lichen pile is familiar, but plain and boring. This is different. Aha! We'll tell them how to find their own. You tell them to follow little damp trails left by little damp snails. They eat the lichen, lichen too, you explain. Smark and Gobclaws both grin. You eat the lichen, 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 lichen. Delicious. I hope that word doesn't pop up again. It's kind of embarrassing. Let's get into this fight. Blistree climbs on top of the lichen, lichen pile. God damn it, that word! She refuses to let any other monsterlings eat, proclaiming herself ruler of the lichen, lichen pile. No, 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 no. I am the monsterling god. Charge at Blistree. She's an idiot, find an elder, destabilize the pile, gang up on her, gang up on her, General Mr. Police Gaming. Cleverness! You gather a small force of monsterlings to teach Blistree a lesson, what will you do? Charge in as a group, or split up and distract her? Charge! Ferocity! You gather the other monsterlings and scream, everyone rushes it simultaneously, Blistree glides out of the way just in time to avoid certain doom. I'm still not very brave. I feel like if I'm leading troops, I should be getting bravery for this. Let's look at the snake. What's the noise from the spawning vat? You rush over and see a big snake eating helpless morsels. They moan and cry, but it doesn't stop. What? Bring it on, snake! Eh, not your problem, they're just morsels. Who doesn't eat morsels? Eat some too. Let's fight the snake. I have monster camaraderie. You puff yourself up to your full height and approach the snake. It swallows another morsel whole. Stand between the snake and morsels. Hey snake, you're what's for dinner? Fear? Not here. Wrestle the snake away from the vat. Yeah, let's wrestle it. Wrestle! Let's give it the five knuckle shuffle. You get your claws around the snake's body, just behind its head. It crawls around you, but you roll away from the vat and out of the cave. The snake crawls away as you laugh and shout. Last day. Last day. Last chance. Get some more cleverness up in this. Let's go with the explanation guy. You've been chatting with Gobclaws and Blistree when a foul stench wafts in. Monsterlings all over the cave are shivering and holding their nose. Yuck! What is it? It's Blots, Gobclaws says. Someone's got to tell him. He stinks. But not the way monsters should. Blots sees your group and makes his way over. Gobclaws and Blistree retreat. Blots doesn't have good luck. I threw him to spiders, and then I helped him build a tower, and now I've got to talk to him about his smell. So we could either talk to him about it, or gluck, he's a tower of stink, get away. I'm going to do what I would do in real life, and I would run away. Aw, damn. You throw a bit of rotten lichen at Blots, which actually makes him smell a little better. He slumps and waddles away. Poor Blots. Oh my, you wake up and find that you're no longer a little monsterling. You're growing up. Wow. Elder Marinus calls the oldest monsterlings to gather in the group. You're one of the oldest ones now, so you should join them. She looks grave. Go with Elder Marinus, hide and watch, see what's going on. Oh, let's just go with her. Marinus shuffles down the long tunnel, turning this way and that, among dozens of forking passages. Keep going! Marinus stops in a warm, humid chamber with a pit in the floor. She points to the pit, which seethes with thick mist. Jump right in, or wait for her to make you go. Well, I don't know what's in there. I'm waiting. Marinus pushes you in with a sweep of her tail. Ah! Or playfully swipe at her tail with your claws as you fall. Yeah, let's drag her down with me. You fall and fall some more. And fall and you're falling, and other monsterlings are falling. Yes, some of them are crying. And you can't see through the mist. Or is it fog? Maybe clouds? Moans and groans and whispering screams. Where am I? I must be somewhere. You land on a smooth flat stone. Despite the swirling vapour, the floor is dry as a bone. You hear other monsterlings breathing nearby. Some of them are still above you, still falling. Get out of the way. Try to cushion the fall for other monsterlings. I read that wrong. I don't know how I read it, but in my head I read that as try to cushion the fall with other monsterlings. So I thought I was going to grab a random monsterling and put it under another monsterling, just arbitrarily. I'm going to do that, and I'm going to just mentally in my head think that's what it says. Oof, you don't see who you helped. Whoever it is rolls away into the thick fog without a word. Gratitude's not important, I'm just here to help. You rejoin some of the monsterlings at the edge of the mist. There are more passages out here than you can count. Some monsterlings begin to panic while others look determined. You should take charge, or maybe someone else should lead. I should lead, obviously. The other monsterlings watch you curious. Lead the way personally. Slash the others to show them you're in charge. Help everyone work together. I'm going to lead the way personally. I'm a lead from the front kind of guy. Yeah, give me that bravery. You strike out with courage and confidence. The other monsterlings follow you, choosing turns and forks at random. You soon walk into a cave full of even thicker mist. Such thick mist. The chamber swirls with mist, smoke, fog, vapour, except it's not any of those things. It's ghosts! Hundreds of them, large and small. They're everywhere. Spooky! One by one, the pale ghosts begin to turn their attention to you. Their eyes glow different colours. Stand fast or cringe a little. I'm going to cringe a little, I'm scared of ghosts. The ghosts speak in many voices, all hollow and distant, all in unison. They ask you, do you fear? Yes, this is scary. Attack them. Wait and say nothing. I'm not going to say to a ghost, yes, this is scary. I'm going to wait and say nothing, because I'm actually urinating myself. The ghosts stare into and through you as though you're the one made of mist. One sharp voice speaks from behind you. Why are you here? How do you do a sharp voice? Why are you here? Yeah, it's good. Lecture the ghosts about the monster life cycle. Attack them. Bide your time. I'm going to lecture them about the monster life cycle. You take a deep breath and begin to explain how monsterlings make the change into adolescent monsters. Stress is like heat cooking our minds and bodies so they can enter a new state of being. Continue explaining things to the ghost. You go on. First, our growing bodies must be destabilized so we can take on our yawn. More divorce forms. And then we must... I'm sorry, I forget where I was. Fall into a deep sleep. Here's how you're going. I'm very clever, I'm not too bright, and I'm not very kind. That's how I'm not too bright. I'm very clever, I'm not very brave, is what I meant to say. That sounds like me. You wake up inside a well-appointed hovel. This is your home now. What should I be doing? The more brave, clever, ferocious, kind, and honest you are, the more other monsters will respect you. Gain enough respect and you might someday affect important world events. Okay. So I guess I'll start living as an adolescent monster. I have 8 days left. There's nothing to click except for enter the big bad world. There's nothing else to click except for adventure in town. Oh, and I've got this adventure thing again. Seems very familiar. This doesn't seem... I didn't know that this was going to be a point-and-click game when I first started. I will be honest. It's two spiders again. You find Bliss Tree crouched in the forest, petting a rather furry spider. It doesn't look too good. In fact, it's not moving at all. Examine the spider. Encourage Bliss Tree and move on. Help Bliss Tree help the spider. Prod the spider awake with a stick. We'll examine the spider. Spider is furry, but it should be much furrier. Patches of its stiff hair falling out. Its eyes are dull. And did it just cough? You didn't know spiders could cough. Okay, so it's a sick spider. I don't want to help the spider. I don't like spiders. Let's prod the spider with a stick. No kindness. No kindness! You poke at it with a big stick, then a smaller stick, then your own claw, but it still doesn't move. As you and Blistery walk away, you swear you could hear it say, Rosebud. I don't understand that reference. Isn't Rosebud like the cheat from The Sims to get lots of money? I guess I'm going to adventure in the town again. Let's do this scared one. Nash Gnash is picking on the tiny Blistery. She gets knocked down every time she gets up. Blistery is a girl? Nash Gnash asks if you want to help. Ask why she's doing that to Bliss Tree. Wait, they're both girls? Walk away. Nash Gnash is insane. Help Nash Gnash hurt Bliss Tree. I'd rather fight you, Nash Gnash. I'd be like, yo man, what are you doing? So let's ask what's going on. Nash Gnash shrugs. I feel like it. And look at those tears. I see. Well, I don't like a bully, so it's time to fight Nash Gnash. Without even a thanks, Blistery runs away, leaving you and Nash Nash to tussle in the street. Do you push the attack? Yes. Claw, bite, kick, or no, Blistery is safe. It's always claw, bite, and kick. It's a motto I live by. Nash Nash is savage, but she's tired herself out and you're full of energy. You beat Nash Nash to a pulp, Nash Nash pants. Impressive. Okay, well, I think I'll call an end to that right now. It's safe to say that we've been playing the game for a little over 20 minutes and nothing has happened yet. So, yeah. I don't know if it's worth the $10 that I paid for it, but it's definitely interesting. It's definitely different. So if it looks like it's your kind of thing, yeah, it's on Steam right now. It just became available today and it's $8.97, I believe. Thanks for watching. Make sure you tell your friends.